Hi everyone, my name is Ariel and I'm a graduate of UNC Chapel Hill where I majored in information science.
Hey guys, and I'm Michael. I'm also a graduate of UNC Chapel Hill. I worked in mathematics there and we're both data science interns at SAS. And for today, we want to show you how you can combine SAS and Python code in a single notebook with just three lines of code. And Ariel's going to demonstrate that for us now.
For this demo, I'm using Jupyter Notebooks. And I'm using it through the Anaconda distribution. We found that this was a really easy way to present things since it's like an interactive notebook. Just to start, I'm going to import the SASPy library. And this is actually a Python library, open source library that is maintained by SAS. And it's actually hosted on GitHub. And if you want, you can go check it out. We'll put the link in the description below. But in this case, once the library has been imported, I'm just going to establish a SAS session and I'm just going to name that SAS. And then I'm going to call the SASPy library and then name the SAS session. And in this case, you can see there is like, it's using an ODA or OnDemand for Academics profile. And there's a little bit of setup that goes into this. So again, we'll put the instructions for that below as well.
Awesome. And now we already have the connection running. So at this point, your ODA server and your Python session are already connected.
Yeah. And so in this case, I'm going to load in a cars data set using the SAS library, SAS Help.
And for those of you who are less familiar with SAS, the SAS Help library is a set of different data sets that ship with SAS that you can work with. And as soon as you're signed up for ODA, you have access to these as well.
Yeah, so once I've named that data set cars data, I can just run it and the data will pop up. And then you can do analysis on this data as you would anything that you kind of work with in Python.
Awesome. So let's talk about why do I actually want to do that, right? Because I might be familiar with Python, like Ariel and I from our university background, we worked a lot with open source technology prior to coming to SAS. And then at SAS, we started learning about some of the cool technology that's available there. But why do we actually want to combine those two?
Yeah, so coming from a Python perspective, I was really using things like string manipulation, like regex, which was really helpful for like large documents. But there wasn't really like Python is not as good for processing large data sets, especially if you're limited by your computer's processing powers. And so I was really using SAS to process these large data sets since ODA was hosted in the cloud or is hosted in the cloud. So that made it a lot easier for me to process these large data sets because they're SAS is processed in the cloud. And so everything runs faster in the cloud.
Exactly. And, you know, in my own work, I really like that Python is a general computing language. So it's really good at interacting with APIs and the string manipulation, which is great for data gathering and pre-processing. But yeah, SAS is great for once you have more than a million rows in your data set, then having SAS hosted in the cloud just starts being a really great benefit. And also SAS comes with just really great mapping capabilities. So, you know, a big problem that we've seen often in our academic work is that, you know, we have these different languages, they have different strengths, and life can be better, life can be more efficient in research if I can find a way to combine them. And that's where the SASPy package together with ODA really shines, because it allows me to combine my SAS software and my SAS skills together with my Python software and Python skills into just one notebook where I can show off my skills and solve problems that I'm interested in. So, for example, we've all been affected by the SARS-CoV-19 pandemic. And early last year, I wanted to see how the how everything was spreading throughout the US. And I wanted to make my own map for it. And so I used Python and SAS together to do that. So as you can see here in my first two lines, I'm importing SASPy and I'm creating a SAS session to connect to ODA, just like what Ariel was just showing you.
Yeah, and notice here how Michael named his SAS, like that connection line, SAS session. It doesn't actually matter what you name it. You can name it like something completely irregardless of SAS. It just makes it easier to keep track of.
Exactly, because it's just a general Python object at this point that's really providing that bridge between my Python code and my SAS code. And then one neat feature of it is that I can use my SAS session object to submit pure SAS code. If there is a method that's not supported yet by SAS Py, I can just give it a string that includes just pure SAS code, if I know how to use it, that then runs on Oda and that I can interact with. So in this case here, I'm downloading the New York Times dataset for all the US counties, which at the time was more complete than I wanted to work with. And then having started with it, I can then move that data back into Python for further processing with the SD2DF method, after which point now, as you scroll through the data set, I'm starting to work with pure Python code here. As I process my data, I get census information moved in, and I update my cases to be no longer raw case numbers, but instead be cases per 100,000 residents. And then here you see, you know, just a simple Python line graph. This I can do in Python, I can do this in SAS. But what I really wanted to do is have it all plotted on a map of the United States. And that was something where SAS really shines. If you've ever tried working with shapefiles, it can be complicated. And you can definitely do this in Python too. But in SAS, you know, I can do it in 5 lines of code. So it's really easy to work with. The shapefiles for the whole US already come packaged together with SAS in the maps GFK library. So here I have just 5 lines to create a choropleth map of the United States, where you can kind of visualize the caseload in different parts of the United States, the cumulative caseloads in the United States for different parts on the geography.
And is there a reason? Oh, sorry, Michael.
No, go ahead.
Is there a reason why you're doing this in SAS, like, versus Python? Because there are, like, Python libraries like Seaborn, and even, like, Matplotlib, I think, can also do this.
Right. So there are ways to accomplish the same thing in Matplotlib and Seaborn, but it takes a lot more work, in fact, to actually get this to work out, because you have to, in that case, then interact directly with shapefiles, which you have to download from somewhere, and they can be a little tricky to work with if you're not experienced with them. And SAS allows me, even with limited knowledge of GIS and shapefiles, to get started and get this map going with just a handful of lines of code, because it ships with SAS and it's just built into the software, which is really nice. And if you don't like the choropleth map where you have different discrete levels, you can even, with just slight changes in your code, turn it into a heat map, which we have here in the ProcSG GMAP version of the same code, where you can see a continuous mapping between the color and the caseload in different parts of the country, which gives you a little bit more detail for each state compared to the previous map. And again, it's just 5 lines of code. And here I am, and I have a visualization that's really easy to do. It doesn't require me to download any additional data sets or figure out exactly how shapefiles work or any of that stuff. I can just go ahead with what's built into SAS and get going with my visualization.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, and if you guys want to check out this notebook, well, also, again, I've been like linking a lot of things in the description, but everything that we've mentioned plus more will actually also be in the description below. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment with any questions that you guys might have. We would love to see what you guys think of it, think of this video. And if you guys want more content, remember to subscribe to the SAS Users channel. And we hope this video has been helpful.